Our magical Christmas begins with our journey to a small, sleepy town tucked in a valley among the peaks of the Rocky Mountains of Colorado. We're going to see the Christmas Festival that has been a yearly event for as long as we can remember. It's this time of year that this small town shines a little brighter than any other among the snow-capped, uneven peaks. We've heard those who live in Georgetown are known for their kindness. Kindness is shown to one another all year long there, but at Christmas time, it gradually warms and kindness turns into love. And everyone knows when there's enough love, unusual things can happen. The residents of Georgetown strive so hard to share their love of the season and welcome anyone who would like to enjoy their festivities. Each shop and home are adorned with lights and decorations to celebrate the birth of Jesus, which is why we celebrate Christmas. It's also this time of year that magic can occur for all to witness. Did you know that animals are amazing? And sometimes they can be influenced by a miracle or magic. I know a thing or two about magic and miracles, and there's a big difference between the two. There's a story in the Bible where a donkey stopped three times on the road and wouldn't move no matter how hard his owner prodded him. It wasn't until the donkey actually spoke words, just like a human, that his owner understood why he would not walk forward, because they were in the presence of an angel. That would be considered a miracle, but not magic. What happens in our story is not a miracle, but it is magic. Yes, magic it was. Christmas magic indeed. Like the donkey, our story is about our dog, Cuddly Kaya. We arrive in Georgetown, and I began unloading Kaya from her car seat. I always think she's so cute. I usually kiss her on the head, but this time I also playfully tapped her on the nose.
Look where we are now!
And that is when the magic began. Here, we were surrounded by happy couples and families as they explored local shops and gathered for all the fun. When magic happens, it feels different. You get a little chill up your spine and your scalp tingles. Somehow you know it's real, and it is to be enjoyed and not questioned. But my busy mind couldn't resolve the fact that our instant arrival seemed to be a result of being playful with Kaya and showing her my love. I felt I had to reconstruct what I did and see if it would happen again. A train depot, huh? Kaya is clearly up to something, and I am beginning to see a pattern. She didn't want us to get distracted and miss any of the fun here. Or maybe she was ensuring we wouldn't miss any of the fun for her. I heard a whistle, a train whistle. Well, the only logical thing to do now is find the train. And the way to do that is to go where all the people are gathered. We saw a Christmas train pulling into the station. The engine had a giant twinkling snowflake on its nose. Each train car was draped with colorful Christmas lights. Through the windows, I could see smiling parents and grandparents gathering their belongings and then grasping their child's sticky hand as they departed the train and followed the conductor's directions. Paul and I both heard kids excitingly discussing riding past the one lone Christmas tree deep in the forest. You see, each year, that tree changes from blending into the forest to a colorful, twinkling Christmas tree lighting up all the trees around it. And it's decorated by an unknown, unseen lover of Christmas. Each night around dusk, animals who live in the forest mingle peacefully and lie down in the snow beneath the tree. Its long evergreen boughs shield the animals from the cold winter winds that gust through the mountains. Colorado is a special place with lots of wonderful mountain towns, and a Colorado Christmas is very special indeed because there's magic in the air.
What if that's a word by myself?